worked as a crime writer, all of the what I call hyphenated writing, thriller writing, crime writing, and so forth and so on, are legitimate exercises, and sometimes they can be quite lucrative. But I wanted to be an unhyphenated writer. I wanted to be a writer pure and simple, not a writer of specific genres. Hungary, being an ally of Germany rather than an occupied country, was permitted to do whatever it wanted to do with its own Jews. I think I was maybe 14 when I joined a motorcycle racing club, and I raced for a few years, and then I came to Canada, and I had other things to do, and I didn't even look at motorcycles until I was probably in my late 40s. In the late 1980s, I took a couple of years off, and I went to the racetrack every weekend, and I pushed bikes and loaded bikes, and ate an immense amount of junk food, and enjoyed myself tremendously. The comfortable age of 52, and I was really too old for a midlife crisis, but I thought that I could indulge myself to return to the track. I needed an excuse. I couldn't just go back to the track by myself, so I had to set up a motorcycle racing team and write a book about it. And the book became A Passion Observed. Most people believe that motorcycle racers or parachutists or people who do certain gladiatorial sports have a death wish, and they're crazy. The fact is that these people don't have a death wish and are not crazy, but they are looking for a certain experience that is available only in the presence of mortal danger. To some extent, I suppose it is like a runner's high, a chemical experience, because your brain produces certain chemicals certain situations. I think that most people get this out of their system when they are teenagers or in their 20s. A few people never get it out of their system, and they spend a lifetime chasing that high or thinking about it or writing about it or watching others chase it. And they're a minority, but I think I'm maybe a member of that minority. There is a word that motorcycle racers, or car racers for that matter, use very often, and it's called the line. The line is not necessarily the shortest, but the fastest way to get around the corner. And of course, that line runs at the edge of things, on the other side, on the wrong side of that line, is the possibility of injury, harm, death, and you find the ideal line in a close proximity to the end of existence. Yes, I'm a person who needs to be convinced that and looks at received wisdom and tries to decide for himself whether it is wise or it isn't wise. And if I conclude that it is wise, as I often do, then far from being a contrarian, I echo very much the majority commonly accepted. I do coming out of the rain. I cherish common sense. I have been diagnosed with probably every neurological illness known to mankind in the last 5 years. And it has slowed me down in a number of ways. I don't ride motorcycles anymore. I still fly. Flying is an interesting occupation in that after you have taken off and settled en route, there is literally nothing for you to do in a modern plane until you arrive someplace. And it can be unbelievably boring, especially if you don't have a hawk to accompany you outside and do aerobatics for you. So I very often write some poetry in my head while I'm flying.